Yeah, I always thought it would be funny since Wings has been doing his weight loss thing. If I made a video log where I gained 25 pounds and then lost it faster than he could lose 25 pounds.
I got you beat by 60 like, already, Dan.
Lap him.
Yeah, like I could gain 25 and then lose it before he could lose 25. Like you know, in that amount of time. I definitely can gain 25 in a week. Like, I mean, I'm sure. Like, I
no
can
way.
Eat.
How would you gain 25
You'd
pounds?
Have to do nothing.
How many
to eat a whole lot.
All right,
that'd be
this.
A lot,
not
dude.
Poop at all.
All you gotta do is think about it. How many calories equals a pound?
3,500.
Okay.
But again, also got to take into effect a guy your size, metabolism, it'd probably take you upward to 6,000 to 7,000 calories to gain 1 pound.
Probably so. I can. So you're telling me that I've got to eat what?
I'd say at least 5,500 calories a day and do nothing to gain 1 pound.
Do you think that's hard for me?
Kyle's like, that's my skill set, bitch. I can do that. This is my core competency.
This is what I did today. All right. I woke up at 11 only because I had to go do a viewing on a house that I'm looking at. Got back home at 1, took a fucking nap. All right. I woke up at 7.
You have my condolences because looking at something is pretty exhausting. Go on.
Yeah. I've eaten 4 times today. I woke up, I ate half a pizza that was left over from the night before, and I poured that garlic shit all over it. And that's nothing but like butter sauce. Like, I've had, like, 18 sodas today. I drink nothing but, like, Coca-Cola and, like, and beer. And then I had one of those birthday cake milkshakes from Zaxby's. That thing's got to be at least 1,000 calories on its own. And then I got,
24 again. Dude, if you were 7,000 like me, you would weigh 7,000 pounds. You would just be outrageous.
You know, Kyle, so far you've took in 3,000 calories. You still got about...
Oh, we've covered his breakfast, dude. I'm like what's that Olympic swimmer?
Michael Phelps, right?
Yeah, I'm like Michael Phelps. All right, I'm his level.
SNL did the greatest skit on that. They're like, "Oh, you want to be a champion like Michael Phelps? This is the Michael Phelps diet."
Man, he's eating like pancakes and omelets and like several bowls of cereal and like sausages and like tons of pasta, like pounds of pasta, crazy stuff. Like, just cramming the carbs because he's just burning so many calories every day. It's nuts. Yeah. That guy's a machine. But but my body just kind of melts fat away. I've put on a little bit of weight since I got back from Chicago. But, like,
here's what's bad. My brother brought a pizza in last night, and I felt bad about myself all day for eating one piece of it this morning.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So when I started my little weight loss thing, I had determined that Thursday lunch was my cheat day. Thursday is the day I go into work, and I always go out to lunch with the people I work with. So it's like, all right, I'm going to have chicken quesadillas on Thursday at lunch. And then every other meal all week long will be healthy without snacks. That's primarily how I'm losing weight. So I kind of still feel guilty, but I allowed myself a cheat meal once a week. It should be okay. Wings, man. So when you first announced that you were going to get serious about weight loss, people were writing me to send messages on to you that they had weight loss expertise. And only now do I realize what a disservice I did you in even passing those on. Like, I must have 2,000 people so far who've told me how to lose weight, who've told me that I'm... I had a guy leave a comment on my video that if you lose more than a pound a month, it's impossible, that you're necessarily only losing muscle. A pound a month? Really? Aim a bit higher, brah.
Real bad advice I got. That's why I went to a personal trainer.
Yeah, and you went to a weight loss specialist doctor,
yeah.
Right? Like an
MD. I went to a doctor and also got a personal trainer now.
Yeah, me and Woody were talking about this the other day, how, like, we were talking about that thing where, like, you know, people say, oh, if you stop eating, your metabolism just shuts down and you don't lose any weight. Dude.
That's not true.
It's not. It's bullshit, okay? Now, maybe bullshit, if you're a fucking 120-pound girl, that's true, Yeah, if you're a little girl, that's true. And that's what most of that fitness shit is written about. It's written for little girls who are going to be anorexic and puking their guts out to lose 8 pounds. No. Bullshit. I'm a man, all right? When I stop eating, I lose fat. I had to...
exactly.
If I had to fit into these, like, size 30 paintball pants before I went to Chicago, I had 2 weeks. They were, like, 4 inches too small. Like, they didn't even button. I was fitting things nicely when I got to Chicago, son. I dropped 15 pounds in like 14 days. I was losing
in 10 days, I've lost 9 pounds so far. And when I put up the first video, everybody was like, oh my God, you know, what are you doing? This and that. I put up the second video and they're like, how'd you do that? Like, because it kept going. You know, they were like, oh, don't. One advice I get all the time is not to weigh myself every day. And the rationale goes like this. If you weigh yourself every day, on those days where you gain, because this is what happens, you'll lose like a pound and a half, and then you'll gain like 0.3, and then you'll lose like, you know, 0.75 pounds, gain 0.1, etc. So I just look at it and I'm like, oh, the downward trend. Today I had a big drop. I had a drop of like a pound and a half. When I weigh myself tomorrow, if I go up a half or something, it's cool. Look, I never lost a pound. Yeah, over the course of 2 days, exactly. And but they're all like, dude, you're gonna get stressed, and then when you get stressed, your metabolism is gonna get ruined and you won't lose weight, and you'll fall into a depression and this and that if I weigh myself daily. Gosh. It's like, first of all, I, you know, dude, I'm not that fragile, I'll be fine. Second, you want me to weigh myself once a week? You don't know shit about making YouTube videos, bruh. You know, like, yeah. There's, I'm trying to put on a show here. So,
And you're
maybe
also
that's why you're asking me advice about asking YouTube.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Can I go ahead and kill some of these myths, since I've learned a lot about weight loss?
Let's hear it. Maybe I'll learn something.
All right. The way you lose muscle, the only time that you're obviously going to lose muscle if you lose a large amount of weight. But if you're dropping 10 to 20 pounds, you're not going to lose any muscle unless you are 100% in a coma or you're 100% take all protein out of your diet. Like a guy asked me the other day that he was young and he wanted to gain muscle, but he'd go and work out and work out and work out and he'd not get stronger. And I'm like, what do you eat? He's like, well, I eat cereal and I eat bread. I'm like, dude, to gain muscle, you got to feed muscle. You got to put protein in there.
Mm-hmm.
And as long as you keep a high level of protein up, like chicken, beef, meats, I got a lot of protein, or like take protein drinks, that's how you gain muscle, and you'll keep your muscle up like that. If you can lose weight by turning your house down to like 60 degrees, because your body shivering will burn 1,500 extra calories a day. And if you shake your leg, you'll burn 1,000 calories a day.
Yeah, and it's not even a matter of like shivering, you know, just your body having to maintain its body temperature at a slightly lower temperature. You know, you don't have to turn it down like an ice box. But yeah, 60 degrees, you lose more weight.
Think about eating as putting gas in a gas tank of a vehicle. Your body's going to use energy no matter what you do. I could sit in this chair, and as long as I ate right, I would lose weight. Because if I use more than I put in, I'm going to lose weight. The big thing you want to watch is carbs. The reason carbs are so bad is not because they're bad for you or they do bad things to you. It's because your body takes so long to break them down. And generally, a person with a so-and-so slow metabolism will eat a lot of carbs. Because when carbs stay in there, they stay in the pockets of fat. Everything you eat goes into your body and goes into a fat cell. And these cells, if you load up on carbs, these cells are going to get all these carbs in it, and that cell's going to stay open. And your body's going to instantly want to try to fill them. So if you eat a bunch of carbs and then you go out and eat like a big ice cream bowl, well, all that calories you just took in from the ice cream is going to go right into that fat cell and stretch it. And next thing you know, you have stored fat. And if you don't do anything, like you sit around, you get fatter and fatter. That's why I was talking about Kyle. It takes a lot of devotion to gain a lot of weight really fast. Like you ever see high school wrestlers? They're sitting there pounding like ice cream, eating pizza. But the fact is, they're doing all that weightlifting, and their body's constantly feeding and building new muscle. They can't keep weight on. Yeah. Same thing with Michael Phelps.
My diet at the moment is almost purely meat and vegetables. That's like what I eat.
That's basically all I eat. Meat. I eat meat and like grapes, and sometimes I'll have like some eggs.
Yeah, I was going to ask you that, Wings. Have you completely cut sweets out of your diet, like altogether, or?
Yeah, no sweets, like no sweets, no Coke. I don't even drink Diet Coke because I don't even want the sugar. Yeah. I drink mainly water, and I do get a little bit of sugar cheat because I do drink Crystal Light, which is like a packet form. You can get they're like $3 for a packet of like 12 of them, and those 12 make 6 pitchers of it, like tea pitchers. And they have no carbs or no calories or anything like that. It's a good alternative if you get bored of drinking water, which you will.
And the, you know, that thing, like I had Cheat Thursday, and that was like from the get-go. Like I think everyone's heard that diets are especially hard to maintain if you don't allow yourself at least a little bit of a break. And, you know, that's it, you know. Cut yourself some slack, but not too much.
I mean, if you want to eat a piece of pizza or a piece of cake, do it. Just moderize it.
Oh, are we okay for next topic?
Yeah.
Yep.